Hello, my soccer universe. Well, I thought I'd show you also during the national break some international shirts. And I went recently through the file of my collection and I saw which is the oldest shirt or which is the shirt that I have the longest that I have not shown you in a video yet. And turns out it's not a European shirt, although I'm all European, I'm wearing Austria. No, it is this Argentina shirt. My first ever Argentina shirt. And as you can see, if you look a little bit closer, something's a little bit off with this one. This is, of course, a 2008-2009 look, which with the crest kind of stowed away, was the one that the Argentinians won the Olympic Games in 2008, the gold. In World Cup qualifying, was so and so with these. However, I got this in 2000, early 2010 or late 2009. I want to say 2010. I remember it was a spring where suddenly I was still in America and they had this great World Soccer Store. This was a great website where fun stuff. I was living in North Carolina and I always wondered when I order from there, I get the orders really fast. Turns out that their storage place was just 45 minutes drive from me in Mebane. I was living in Greensboro, and I always thought, my, it would be nice to have a tour and be allowed to kind of pick three or four shirts or whatever. I mean, this would have been the greatest thing. I also have to say, like almost, and we get to the shirt, like almost every great soccer store where they start with a whole lot of variety, very soon it becomes only the big teams. And I think this is where they are again, which is always a little bit of a shame to see. So, but back to this Argentina shirt. So they were selling, of course, them this off. And I think I got this, I want to say 25 or 20 euros, no, dollars back then. It was really cheap. And I said, okay, I don't have an Argentina shirt. I really like Argentina. We might as well get it. And I don't dislike the overall design. And then at the same time, my brother was expecting his first son. And I thought, ah, I can get also free printing. Let's make it a little bit special. And of course, I chose the official one. If you see some of my Austria shirts, there's an unofficial print on there that they would have bought. But I said, no, let's go official. I get it. And I'm thinking, something doesn't look quite right. I got number 10. Something doesn't look quite right. Then I realized, yeah, this is the style for 10-11 and not the 2008 style. It literally took me 2 days, but I knew it looks off. So yeah, it's kind of a weird style. Why did I choose only number 10? Well, of course, 10. I didn't want to decide between Maradona and Messi. And also the son of my brother was about to call Diego. So I always call this my Diego shirt because, you know, he's Diego Lionel. First name, yeah. So you have both of them in there, so I didn't want to. It was another reason to choose. I have worn this a whole lot. What I really like about this, and I'm not sure if the camera can pick it up very nicely, that there, yeah, maybe here a little bit, there is a huge Argentina crest with all kinds of ornamentations in as a shadow print in here. The Argentina crest, the AFA crest, is only like this side, and then there's this whole shield. It really looks beautiful, but I think it's really hard that the camera picks it up. Maybe, yeah, maybe you can make it out a little bit, but it's really hard, and the stripe pattern doesn't really help. But you see, there's a huge shadow print, which is really nice. The Argentina crest, of course, all stitched with gold, which I really like. And what I really like overall is that, you know, I love my Argentina Adidas jerseys like that. You have the blue in the middle, which is what I prefer, and then, you know, it's kind of thickish but not too thick striping. I like it a little bit thin, but I never did, minded it. And then you have the black accents. Could the collar be black? Maybe. And the only weird thing is that this patch here for the ventilation, that is one thing I don't like. I also, the shield here is nice because it's really nicely done, but I think it's unnecessary. I think a pure striped look would actually look better here. I have worn it quite a bit, so you can already see the Argentina back here is a little bit damaged as all the inside details are washed out. But yeah, this was for a long time absolute favorite jersey of mine to wear because I got an XL. It is very comfy. It has this loose cut that I absolutely love. Of course, we have here Adidas and the Climacool, so it's a replica version. I cannot say anything really bad. One reason, what I want to mention, why I got the number, of course, is it looks a little bit disbalanced. If you have here the Adidas logo and then this would be empty, this looks weird to me. So I need the number to balance out the crest so it makes for a little bit better look. Yes, would be nice to get the original set on there, but on the other side, you know, this makes this shirt a little bit more special. So yeah, what do you think about this? I would say beautiful Argentina jersey. This is I have not has been a while that Argentina had nah, I shouldn't say that. Argentina usually has always nice jerseys, although I like away jerseys better, especially if they're navy blue. Not super dark as in 2008 or 9, but more like the 98, 2002 and 2006 World Cups. That's my favorite Argentina away jersey color. So yeah, let me know what you think about this jersey. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. I will talk to you soon. Bye! I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel as it will keep you updated on all the things that are rotating in my soccer universe. And with that, I'm going to wish you a wonderful day. Bye.